Hello friends, in this video we'll discuss about the sales order and the sales documents, document type, how to create the new document type in the sales order. We are going to discuss in this video, so just enter into the navigation path. So before I'm creating a sales order, I just want to create a new sales document type. So for that, I just enter into the sales and distribution. So you can see the sales and the sales document. So these are the three things that need to be configured before creating a sales order. First is the sales document header, a sales document item, and the schedule lines. So first I move into the sales document header. So the header contains, sales order contains these three things that are header, that it can be categorized into header, item, and schedule lines. So first we will configure the parameters associated with the header level and then into the item level and then to the schedule lines. So first I enter into the sales document header, where I can create the sales document types and all these things. So before enter into the sales document type, I just create a document range for a sales document so that I can assign the number range to the sales document type. So just first create the number ranges, enter into the intervals, just create a new number range. So I know that the 46th number is not available with this existing number ranges. You can see here there is a lot of number ranges. Okay, even I can see that the 30th number range is also missing, so I just go to the 30th number and this is the number range for my sales document. So the first number is 15001 and the end number is 16000. So the current number, that is the first number, is this. If I create a sales order, the sales order will have the number 15001. Let me save it. Okay, then click on save. So the document number is now saved. It is, you can see that in the number is 30, I think so, yes, 30th. So if I create a document number, I can assign this 30 number in my sales document type. So let me do it. Okay, define sales document type. So just enter executing it. So the default document type is OR. You can see, I can show you first. So this is the standard order that is available with SAP. So I'm not going to copy this. I just want to create a new one. I will not use this thing. Just go into the new entry. So my new document type is OR. So let me change additional ORP. So it will be my document type. So this is my company code. So I just have a description like this, and this field is important, ST document category, and this document type is specially for sales. So I just enter the category as C, that is order. So the number range, it is a number range internal assignment, and this goes for the external assignment. So we have created the number range, that is 30. Just now we have created the number range. So I just enter here, and this is the item number increment. So I just go with the 10. so that my first number range, sorry, the first sales document number is 15001, and the second, if I create a new sales document, it will have the number 15010. So it will have an increment of 10. So that is the purpose of this field over here. Similarly, for the external assignment also, it just make the same number range. So it is demanding for the screen sequence group. So let me select the one that suits this sales order. Number range 30 is an internal number range, so I just remove this. I will not make any external number assignment. Okay, it shows entry is already available with this. So let me have another field so that the OR represents the sales order or default sales document type, and BE represents my company code. Okay. So the other fields, we can go into the general control. So we can say the check division. I just go on to this. Okay, if I make the dialogue, so if I make the division field in my sales order, it will display a dialog box, and this credit check credit limit and credit group and all these things I will be configuring when. For now, I will just keep it blank because I have not maintained the credit management, so I just left it for now. And the output application is also similar to the sales order. Let me search it. So here I just go on with the sales V1, that is sales, and the other important things are I just go flag these two parameters. So if I take this read info record, so it will read the information that I have entered in customer material info record. So this enter PO number. So if I want to enter the PO number and into my sales order, I want to check mark here, and this blank space represents no check. So I don't want to give any purchase order number into my sales order. Just leave this fields as blank. So let me process with the next. The transaction flow, I've assigned the screen sequence group. And the document pricing procedure, as we have discussed, I go with the standard one. And the status profile, I have not created any status profile. It represents your release procedure for my sales order. So I just, for now, I'm leaving it blank. We will configure in our upcoming videos. And the other important parameters are. Just go for all items, and this over screen I just go to the this thing, scheduling agreement, shipping. So for now I just leave these things blank, the scheduling agreement, shipping data and billing documents. So when I create a shipping or a billing, when I process these documents, I will include those data at that time. So just leave it blank. And the next is requested delivery date, pricing date, purchase order date. So I just enter the lead time as 5 days. So the system proposes the delivery date in the sales order with this lead time. We will discuss in brief in our upcoming videos. So I just click on a proposed delivery date. Okay, I have not gone with the PO date, so I just leave it blank. And these fields are relevant to contract. And the availability check. just leave it blank. Okay, I think I have maintained all these things. Just click on save. Okay, the data is saved, so I can use the document type ORBE. Just move to the next, that is okay, assign sales. Okay, let me move to the next, that is sales document item level. So at the item level, so what are the configurations required are the item categories and assigning those item categories. So first I execute, what are the item categories available. So there are as much of item categories available with SAP, so I don't want to create any new one, so I can make use of it. So these item categories, so when we create a material, especially the material type, we will be using this item category. So let me show it. We have created a material. Okay, let me show in my material. Let me show what are the materials available with my plant. And we have configured the material in our previous video. Especially those who want to learn those things, kindly refer my previous videos. You can see it on my playlist. So let me open this material in a new tab. I just go to it. Just change the material. So we'll see this. 360. The material type is FBR, that is a finished material type. FBER. Okay. So in the basic view, I just open the basic views. Okay, just go to the sales or data also. So you can see that general item category group represents normal, it's a standard item. So during the material creation, we have this parameter have been came from the material type. So this finished material group has been linked to this item category group. So that thing is only available here. You can see here, just no, it is a standard item category group, but it is not the group. It is just the item category. Let me show it. It will be available in different item category group. Let me first execute it. You can find here. So this is for the standard item. So this item group has been linked to our material. So you can see here. So this group, so by this way, this norm, this function will be called in our sales order. Let me show this item category. Then the item category will be the basic thing, that is TAN. It is a standard item here. So let me show the functions of this item category. So you can see that this standard item will have a pricing, have a standard pricing. So all these, it will allow for schedule lines. It will allow the schedule lines. So all these things I can configure here, especially the bill of material configurations. So I can use this item category. Just So let me use this item category in our assignments. So we have saw what is the item category group, and we can assign the default value for our material type here itself. But, so this field represents assign item categories. So we can see that our item category group, that is non, and the sales document type. Okay, we have not yet linked. We will have a new entry. So our sales document type, just now we have created, that is ORBE, and the item category group, that is norm, and the we have not maintained item usage, just leave it blank, or else we can give the standard one. Just leave it blank. We don't want this. Item category here. Item category is tan, that is a standard item. Okay, just save this entry. So we have assigned our item category. We have assigned the item category to our item category group to my sales document type. So this is very important configuration. So just move to the next. Okay, that is the schedule lines. So here also we need to define the schedule lines and need to assign the schedule lines. So SAP has a lot of schedule line categories. We don't want to create a new one. So let me let me show the some standard one. So in this we will use this CN. So it represents no MRP. So let me open it. You can see the movement type 601 is configured in this schedule line category. So we will going to use this schedule line category in our assignments. Okay. Assign the schedule line categories to our document type. Let me go to the new entry. So we know that item category is TAN. The MRP type, we have not configured any MRP types. So we can see some of the default. So we are, till now we have not gone with the MRP type. So just leave this thing. And the proposed schedule line category is, that is CN, you can see here. For now, I just save this entry. An entry already exists with the same key. So there is no need for this entry. Make sure that all these entries have been available with this thing. Let me show it. The item category is TAN. You can see here. So you can see the entry over here. This is the this is the entry we have tried to configure. So don't worry, this ENT represents no planning. Here I just see it. Here you can see that ENT is here. It is, yes, ENT means no planning. So we have kept it blank. So both are same. So we have the entry over here. So that's why the entry we have given is not saved. Okay, let me. So I think we have configured these three things: document header, document item, and schedule lines. So we can move on to the sales order. So to create a sales order, I just enter the T code BA01. So this is the first screen for our sales order. I just enter my order type, the sales organization, distribution channel, division. So all these things we have configured in our previous video. After giving this, I just go to the click on enter. So these things we have not configured. I just leave this, left this. So these are the important credentials. So, but before entering to this into the sales order, I just missed a configuration. Let me do it. So here the sales, in the sales document header, this field is important. Assign sales area to the sales document types. I just execute it. So combine the sales organization. So I just search my sales org, and I will make it as a reference sales org. Just save this. We have left these things. Just complete it. And our distribution channel, I just make both of the distribution channel as a reference distribution channel. Similarly, combine divisions. The last is assign sales order type permitted for a sales area. Sales order types permitted for sales area. Okay, let me give a new entry. Click on enter so that this thing will be released. So the reference sales org, the reference division. Sorry, this is a distribution channel and this is a division. And the sales order type, that is the configured ORBE. And, click on save. So these things need to be configured before proceeding with the sales order. So I've done these things. So now we can process with the sales order. So then I just click on enter. So here you can see that sold to party field is disabled. I cannot I cannot enter my sales to party here. I can search for my customer, but I cannot enter my customer number here, which means I have to link this new document type to my partner determination. So let me do it. Just close it. I enter into the basic functions. You can see the pricing. So not in the pricing, you can see in the partner determination here. The partner determination, I just entered this setup partner determination. So you can see here set up the partner determination for sales document header. So here I just want to make my new, sorry, the partner determination. So I just use this standard one. So standard partner determination procedure. I just select it and double click on partner function and procedures. So you can see that our partner procedure is linked with the most of the functions. So these functions we have linked in our customer master. So for that I have choose this partner functions, partner determination procedure TA. So this is the main thing, partner determination procedure assignments. Double click on it. So we can see that our order type, sales order type, has to be linked with this partner determination procedure TA. Just click on enter and save it. So we have done the configurations. Let me go to the sales order. So let me again make it by So you can see that the sales to party field is now open. So I can give the customer number now. So just leave the PO number, the material I want to link here. So I just use this material. Okay, the order quantity is 10. So here the item category, just click on enter. It will be automatically updated with the norm NORM. Sorry, it is a TAN. It is item category. So norm is the item category group. So the item category only displays here, that is TAN. So the condition type, in my previous video we have discussed the pricing procedure. So now we will check the pricing procedures. Just double click on this material. So the ordered quantity is 10. Let me enter into the conditions. So let me give the condition types we have configured in our previous video. Price, the condition type price, I will link here. Freight and the customer discount. So these things we have configured. Just click on enter. So let me enter the price. And we are allowing a 5% discount. And the freight is, let me say it is 100 rupees. So you can see the net value will be updated here. It's 9500. So let me go back. And I can. Okay, let me go to the incompletion log. Okay, you can see here the incompletion log. So just click here and click on complete data. So you can see I can enter the gross weight. The next field is the net weight. So in the similar way I can navigate. Shipping point, receiving point. So let me give the plant and the storage location. So we have processed this in our previous videos. Especially this shipping point, I think it will be available in the warehouse management playlist. You can check it there. Here it says the business area can be determined for item. No business area can be determined. Let me check where is the field business area. So to rectify this error, I just go to the enterprise structure. So I just come out from this. So we have a business area configured. So something relevant field for finance. Let me go into the enterprise structure. Let me assign it. I've already created the business area. Let me assign it to the plant. I think it will be available in logistics general. Yes, assign business area to the plant. Okay, let me search for this. It's already assigned. Then what is? So in the assignment field, make sure that all entries have been made. For example, in the logistics general, assign business area to plant. So in this, make sure that all the fields have been entered. And similarly, in the sales and distribution, you can see the business area account assignment. So make sure that all these rules have been defined rules for by sales area. So these three fields have to be configured. So make sure that all the entries have been given. So enter the rule first rule. You can also vary this thing. So the rule one is business area determination from plant division. So by the plant and division, my business area will be determined. So here I've linked my plant and business area. You can see here these three entries. So after giving these and also the third one, I just show you. So these two things, after giving this, I can process. Edit and incompletion log the Incoterms. Just enter the rightest redetermined the terms of payment. So you can see that the document is complete here. Edit next data. Okay, here you can see the document is complete. So now I can save the sales order. So you can see that the document type with the sales order number has been saved. So we can display it. So we can display the order number. So you can see the order value. So by this way we can make our purchase order and the associated document types configuration. This, so we have processed this header level sales document type with header level, item level and schedule lines in this video, and we will continue in the next video. Thank you guys for watching this video.